a little bit that way because I just think we're right, so I just right they're wrong, but that's how I look at it. But I don't, you know, I think I do see a reasonable group of people that are a little bit embarrassed by his behavior, but you know they're all trying to get their minds wrapped around some of the just I think they're trying to rationalize. And I think that's unfortunate, and for all of us who are Democratic AGs, then we tend to be more we have weekly conference calls actually where we're talking about all the different actions that are going to take. I was just on one this morning.
So with all the Democratic
AGs? Yep. And so we all call it. I mean, and that actually started the second week in the administration, has continued 52 weeks later. I mean, we all call it, you know, and it's just once a week. Once a week, and we talk about what's happened. We go through a roll call of the states, and we talk about what each of us are working on. And it's a good opportunity to be able to find out about different efforts that are being made that Hawaii can join in on. Masterpiece Cake Shop case was being argued. That's the one about the bakery that didn't want to sell the cake to a LGBT couple. Then Hawaii ended up taking the lead in terms of writing the amicus brief in support of the couple. So that's like the Friends of the Court brief for the couple. And what was great was that normally Hawaii doesn't take that kind of stand. Usually it's California or New York or something that makes it. But you know, like the great Solicitor General, Clyde Wadsworth, who I think a lot of you guys know, he really lobbied for it and asked for it. And I think because we were involved in that national network at such a intense level, actually, it's like the states allowed us to be leaders in writing this campus brief. And then we had 20 states sign on with us. And so, you know, California, Eric Schneiderman in New York was writing, was signing on to our amicus, and I think it's actually been, I guess the other thing I just want to say about that is that it's because there's so much out there. I mean, you know, every week there's something new that would come at us, that it's almost been a way for us to be able to pool our resources and, you know, kind of say, you know, do immigration, if you do, you know, national monuments, and clean energy. So there's that. And then also, I get thrilled because you're seeing Chief Justice Roberts write about me at the University of Hawaii. But I think the other thing is that I think we do have this great story. I always feel like here we are, we're the 50th state, and yet I feel like here we are, we're like the tip of the spear in being able to really share about how diversity and being welcome and having being a place of aloha, how that actually works. If you actually have that kind of melting pot environment, then in our island communities, we are capable of being able to be very successful in that regard. And so we can share that. I get excited about that. Yes. Oh, great.
As a dreamer and as an immigration activist, I have a question. As you might know, there's two bills in the state ledge that are moving forward. I want to get your take on Hawaii potentially becoming a Hawaiʻi state.
Yes, great. We have there's a bill going through. The people who drafted it actually ended up talking to me about it, and I was able to give them some good comments on it. I think we're set up pretty well legally to be able to defend that bill, meaning that there have been challenges to other sanctuary cities where what would happen is that the Department of Justice was threatened to cut funding for JAG grants. So they were threatening to cut grants to sanctuary cities. So we were actually part of a lawsuit, Hawaii, that was filed in New York. We joined that lawsuit that was getting a court to rule that cutting funding to sanctuary cities is actually discriminatory and unconstitutional. And so we have a judge that's agreed with that. So I think what's good about that, and that also took place in California, so both California and New York had court rulings there. So actually, I think we're well set up to be able to defend that if that's something that the legislature passes. And I think it's the right thing to do. I mean, in other words, the whole point of being a Hawaiʻi state is to be able to say that federal immigration, they have a role to play, but we're not going to use our tax dollars, whether it's state dollars or county dollars, to be able to help the federal government do their job. We're going to focus on our job, which is state and county law enforcement.
Do you anticipate any retaliation? Because this is a different administration. If it were to happen under an Obama administration with Eric Holder in place, now do you anticipate any retaliation from a Jeff Sessions probably tripling the amount of ICE agents in Hawaii and creating havoc and fear amongst the immigrant population?
That's where I say I think we're better set up because of these court rulings to be able to withstand some sort of withholding of funds. I think they've been kind of slapped back on what they did. You might know better than I do, but it just given what you do. But I get the sense that Hawaii's not really on their radar. That in other words, in terms of retaliation, it seems like what Jeff Sessions does is he goes after California. Certainly on the marijuana. Or New York, in other words, he goes after the big states. I don't have that sense that Hawaii is necessarily in the crosshairs. My estimation of what that's like doesn't.
The early Jewish immigrants in Germany were more well-to-do than simultaneously clean our own side of the street.
Yep.
If you look at the incarceration in Hawaii, they want to build a new prison to have more beds. And if you look at the racial breakdown in the prisons, you can see how it's predominantly
brown.
Not brown, not white, right? And I don't think that's accidental. I see it in my own neighborhood, people that want to put a gate up to prevent people from going to the beach because this is a private lane, that kind of thinking. I think there's racism, discrimination, this whole setup of the us-them thing is within all of us, and we have to keep fighting it. But you know, my question is, I'm so moved by it.